Here is another free video from the Windows 7 course for the 7680 exam. In this video, I will look at BitLocker To Go. BitLocker To Go allows you to encrypt your USB drives. The advantage of BitLocker To Go is that if you lose your USB drive, which is easy enough to do, anyone who finds it will not be able to read any of the information on it. BitLocker To Go does not require a TPM chip or any other special hardware to operate. In order to configure BitLocker To Go, you need to be running Windows 7 Enterprise or Ultimate Edition. Either of these editions will allow you to read and write files to BitLocker To Go USB devices, as well as configure new USB devices. Once you secure your USB drive with BitLocker To Go using the Enterprise or Ultimate Editions, it can be read on any edition of Windows 7. When BitLocker To Go is configured, reader software is added to the USB drive that can be used by earlier versions of Windows. This allows you to read encrypted files on operating systems such as Windows Vista and Windows XP. All you need to do is put the USB thumb drive in the computer and run the viewer software. While this will allow BitLocker To Go USB drives to be read on other versions of Windows such as Vista and Windows XP, unfortunately, support is only read-only for these operating systems, and files must be accessed from the viewer software. You cannot access the files with Windows Explorer with earlier operating systems. Only the Enterprise and Ultimate editions of Windows 7 will allow you to add or modify files on the USB drive using Windows Explorer. BitLocker also encrypts all the data on the USB drive so it cannot be read by a third party. To access the information on the USB drive, you need to use a password or a smart card. This allows the USB drive to be used on any computer without the need for special hardware such as a TPM chip. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to see how to use BitLocker To Go on a USB thumb drive. To configure BitLocker To Go, first of all, open the control panel and select System and Security. From System and Security, select the option BitLocker Drive Encryption. This is where you also can configure BitLocker to encrypt an entire drive. To encrypt a removable device, notice down at the bottom the option Turn on BitLocker under the BitLocker To Go section. Once this option is selected, this will start the BitLocker To Go wizard. To secure the USB device, the wizard will ask you to enter in a password or give you the option to use a smart card. In this case, I will use a password. Once the password is entered, I can also select the option for smart cards if you wanted to use both. The next option of the wizard will ask you about the recovery key. The recovery key will allow you to recover the information on the USB device if you forget the password or lose the smart card. This option allows you to save the recovery key to a file. The next option will allow you to print the recovery key. The recovery key is quite long, so I will save it to a file on the desktop. Regardless of whether you save it or print it, you will need to keep it in a safe place. The last screen of the wizard will ask you to start encryption on the device. This process does require all the space to be encrypted, even the free space, so it takes a long time. You have the option also to pause the encryption if you wish. It is best, if possible, to allow Windows to do this in one step to help ensure that the process completes correctly. Having said this, I would always back up any data on the device before you start, just in case. Since the process does take a long time, I will pause the video and return when it is completed. When complete, you will receive a message stating the encryption is done. If I now close all the open windows and open Windows Explorer, notice that the removable drive now appears with a padlock. At present, I will be able to read and write to the USB drive. If I remove the USB drive and reinsert it again, notice this time I get Windows asking me for the password to unlock the USB drive. Notice also the option automatically unlock on this computer from now on. Ticking this option will mean that you won't be prompted for the password again. If you are only worried about someone reading the USB drive if it is lost, there is no issue ticking this box. Once I press Unlock, I will be able to read and write to the drive. If I right-click on the drive, I can select the option Manage BitLocker. This will allow you to change the BitLocker settings, and you can also configure BitLocker to go on a new USB drive without having to go through the control panel. Microsoft has also included a reader for BitLocker to go that works on earlier editions of Windows. If I switch to a computer running Windows XP and insert the USB thumb drive into that computer, when I now open Windows Explorer, I have the BitLocker to go executable on the drive. When I run this executable, I will be asked for the password. Notice that the viewer software only lets me read files on the USB drive. I could extract the files from the USB drive to another location and edit them. However, once I make changes to these files, I will not be able to write any changes to the USB drive on earlier versions of Windows. So far, I have looked at how to configure BitLocker to go on one computer using a USB thumb drive. If you are in an enterprise environment, you are more than likely going to want to configure BitLocker to go using group policy. There are 6 settings in group policy that affect BitLocker to go. These are found in Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, Windows Components, BitLocker Drive Encryption, and finally, Removal Data Drive. To look at how to configure group policy, I will change to my Windows 7 computer. First of all, I will open the local group policy editor by running gpedit.msc from the Start menu. Next, I will navigate down to the BitLocker to go settings. The first setting, Control Use of BitLocker on Removable Drives, determines if BitLocker can be used, removed, or paused. Once enabled, the first setting, Allow Users to Apply BitLocker Protection on Removable Data Drives, allows the user to launch the wizard and configure BitLocker to go on USB drives. If you were to clear this, the user would not be able to configure a USB drive to use BitLocker to go. The second setting, Allow Users to Suspend and Decrypt BitLocker Protection on Removable Data Drives, determines if once started, if the user can pause the encryption process. If this option is cleared, the user will not be able to pause the encryption process once it has started. Also, if cleared, the user will not be able to decrypt a BitLocker to go USB drive once it is created. There is nothing from stopping them from reformatting the USB drive, of course. The next setting, Configure Use of SmartCards on Removable Data Drives, when enabled, allows you to use SmartCards with BitLocker to go. Once enabled, you also have the additional setting, Require Use of SmartCards on Removable Data Drives. When this is selected, BitLocker to go will not operate if you do not have smart cards configured. The next group policy setting, Deny Write Access to Removable Drives Not Protected by BitLocker, will do exactly that. If the USB drive is not configured with BitLocker, the user will not be able to write to it. Notice you also have the setting, Do Not Allow Write Access to Devices Configured in Another Organization. In the next video, I will look at configuring a DRA for BitLocker. When doing that, I will also set up an organization name for BitLocker. This setting, when ticked, will prevent USB drives that have a different organization name than yours, and thus belong to a different company, from being accessible. The next setting, Allow Access to BitLocker Protected Removable Data Drives from Earlier Versions of Windows, determines if Windows 7 will be the only operating system that can read the USB device. If you will only be using Windows 7 with BitLocker to go in your organization, you can disable this setting to give you additional security. Notice you also have the option, Do not install BitLocker to go reader on FAT formatted removable drives. When selected, this will save a little bit of space on the USB drive by not copying over the reading software. On most USB drives, the amount of space compared to the size of the software is hardly worth it, but the option is there if you need it. The next group policy option, Configure Use of Passwords for Removable Data Drives, allows you to configure how complex the passwords for BitLocker To Go will be, and even if you require one. It is a little strange that once enabled, you have the first setting, Require Password for Removable Data Drive. You would think you would want to leave this ticked, as not putting a password on a BitLocker To Go drive would make it readable on any system, thus defeating encrypting the device in the first place. If you used smart cards, this option makes more sense, because you may want to give the user the option to use a smart card with a password or just the smart card. The next option allows you to configure how complex the password will be. Allow password complexity will attempt to contact a domain controller to determine if the password is complex enough. If it can't contact a domain controller, it will allow the password anyway. Do not allow password complexity will allow you to use any password you want as long as it has enough characters. Require password complexity means that if a domain controller cannot be contacted to confirm if the password is complex enough, the password will not be allowed to be used. The last option determines how many characters the password must be. The last group policy setting is used with the data recovery agent. The data recovery agent allows you to recover data from BitLocker To Go if you forget the password, lose the smart card, or change your TPM. I won't look at this now because this is the topic of our next video. For more free videos, please have a look at our webpage or YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.